which is very similar in appearance to the striped or the white bass. As a matter of fact, they can even interbreed, and they're also closely related to their cousins, which are the striped bass or the rockfish, and also the hybrid or the Cherokee bass. Okay, the first thing you want to do is seal the fish, and as you can see, we've already sealed the fish and we let it dry. We'll use a base coat sealer, sand and sealer, and I've heard of them using shellac. Just whichever one you prefer. A base coat sealer is fine, plus you don't have to wait for it to dry. I do with a lot of fish, especially on a tinning method. I like to take advantage of natural marks whenever I can. And I want this fish to be real good and bright. So I do with a lot of fish, especially on a tinning method. I like to take advantage of natural marks whenever I can. And I want this fish to be real good and bright. So I opt to go ahead and paint him. And I want to get a good start by probably whiten him out real good. But at the same time, you can take advantage of your spots by using a Sharpie pen, and what this Sharpie pen ink does, it'll the permanent marker, the ink, well, actually when you're painting white and pearling, it actually shows through, and you know where to apply your paint. And you don't have to sit there and guess and look at the scales. And I do this on my rockfish, my my rock bass, and do it on my my white bass, my stripe, and it comes in handy. Anytime you can use original marks, it helps. Let's see, get you in close. We already see the marks, and it's pretty distinct. It's not really broke up or anything. And I don't know how really to describe it, except it looks like a mushroom with the point of the mushroom going this way. You know, like on rockfish, some people say it's like an arrow. But to me, it's more of a mushroom. You know, a little round on the back. But fish are different. All I'm doing is going over my mark, my original marks, with the Sharpie pen. And it looks like there's two below, three below the lateral line. And these bottom ones, they'll break up a little. You know, on a stripe, they're uniform, straight through. You know, on a white bass, but on these, a little bit of a breaking up effect. Now you can also do the straight line effect on the lateral line if you want to, but they do tend to still mushroom out a little bit. In other words, it's not necessarily just a straight line. Although that's what I incorporated on my white bass. That's pretty much what I've done. Yeah, you can add to it and okay, the first color is going to be white. For the sake of a good white bright fish, plus I tend to do all my panfish pretty much this way. I'll whiten the fins first, and at least you're going to know that you're going to have a good bright fish, and you can't go wrong there. Especially on a white fish, you know, where the fish is basically white, you want a white bait. And so I like to paint my fish white when they're a white fish to begin with. Because then all your other colors, except for your stripes, all your other colors are basically kind of like a blushing. Because you know the base coat is supposed to be white. And you know you got to control your paint. Because, any fish is white, if you put more color than what you're supposed to, it's not going to be a white fish. Okay, now I've got the white pearl. And I want the fish to be good and pearly. And so I put a good coat of pearl on it. You can go on the fins, but I mainly worry about the body. A good pearly coat on the cheeks, maxillary, the lower jaw, the lower belly, just make sure it's real good and pearly. Now after you've you put your white on your fish and you pearled it, now's as good a time as any to go ahead and get a Q-tip, put some lacquer thinner on it, roll it one time in a paper towel, and what that does, that gets the excess out so it don't drip down and run your paint job. And now's as good a time as any. That way, when you clean your off again, when you're done, you won't have a white ring around your eye because you went ahead and cleaned your eye off now. So I just think it looks better because a lot of times, well, it is a little noticeable. So what I've got here, I've got a little gray. I got diver gray. I guess you can make it mix black with white, but I want to put just a light coating over the fins. Okay. Now what you can do is in between the stripes, and I suppose you could even go along the back with it. It's, what I've got a little bit of orange mixed with a lot of yellow, about 90% yellow with a little bit of orange. And basically what I've done, I've turned the yellow into kind of a peach color. It's not really orange, it's not really yellow. It's in between. And I'm going to go ahead and apply it. About a light coat. It doesn't take much. Doesn't take much at all. Stay below the back. Right up to the first stripe coming down from the back. That's a good rule of thumb. Part of the jaw and the cheek and gill plate, the lower part, maybe just a little bit on the mouth. A little bit around the eye. little bit on top of the head area maybe. Just a little bit on the spiny ray. Maybe just a hair on the other fin, I mean, where you can barely see it. I mean, extremely light. About a medium to light coat. Something like that. Now I've got blue. This is, I think, sailfish blue, I think, or something like that. Any kind of good blue. And I'm going to go along the back. Just right along the back. And I try not to get on the fins either. I know that's easier said than done. But, carry the blue, kind of taper out before you get to the head, I guess. But just right along the back, mainly. Down to about your first stripe, and that's about it. You know, your first main stripe, I think there's a little one right below the fin. Okay. I've got a little bit of a transparent orange, and I've got it really, really thinned down. And what I want to do is hit mainly down here close to the belly. Kind of lighten up as I go up. Basically, a gold toner would work. Right here in the junctures of the head. I may want to put a little bit of this. Be careful with it. Right here. Area. Kind of a peachy color. If you look real close, you can see where I got with my transparent orange or my gold toner. Right here in the junction area where the top of the gill and the top of the cheek meet, right below the top of the head. And there's a junction area. I went down in there, went around in here. Areas that tend to turn orange on the skin mount if you don't put enough paint on them. Basically those areas, and I gave the yellow an overall peachy color. It's still yellow, but it's got a little bit of an orange to it. Okay, I've got a little bit too much yellow on some of my fins, so I went back to my diver gray, and I may actually take some more of that out. I don't want to cover my blue up on my back. can go in between these pins a little bit with it. Especially down here on the anal fin, all that yellow on there, I'm going to go ahead and take most of it off. Same with the pectoral fin. Take most of it off. Not all of it. Got a little bit of silver metallic. And I've got it stand down. Now what you can do is, for a little bit of effect, come down in between the scales that are going to be black and mark a few scales. Just ever so lightly, you can go all the way through. I mean, so faint you can't even tell you're doing it. Well, as good a time as any to make sure your colors are correct. If some of them are too, if your yellow's too strong or something, you can lighten it up with a little bit of white. Followed by a little bit of pearl. Make sure you get your basic colors right before we proceed any further. Now we're darkening our spot better. And you still should be able to see it if you used a Sharpie pen. But if you didn't, find you a good reference picture and incorporate it back in. The clearer it looks, the better off you're going to be. You have a better looking mount. The belly kind of jumps down a little bit. The marks are similar to that of a stripe, except these break. Till you get past the belly and then they drop. Of course you got another row right here. Enough for there. Yeah, you just put in what you trace. If you look up towards the top, they kind of break off. Row of scales, I'm going to put you a row. And there's two above the two main ones above the lateral line. And looks like three below and then two main ones above. Just darken them in. Got my black. And pretty much what I want to do, I don't want to do much to it except bring out the fins and highlight scales by angle spread. But you got to remember, this fish has basically got a white undertone, so everything you do to it can darken it too much. You got to be super, super careful. It'll be like... thing you probably want to do is just angle spray and try to bring out scales as much as humanly possible. You can do spray from the front. And it don't take much. You could even stand back probably and do enough. It don't take much. You just want to bring the rays out, and that's about it. That. You can even come in from the outside. You may have more, my paint's a little splattery. I don't like that too good. Do the outer extremities of the spiny and soft dorsal with a little bit of black. Of course, I've already pretty much got the spiny and paint an open mouth. This is a closed mouth, so you can't get a good idea. So I'm going to take the time to show you what you do if it happens to be an open mouth. Okay, I start down the tip of the nose, and I ride the lip and let my overspray hit the front of the maxilla. But since the mouth is closed, you can't really see that. But you can see me darkening up the front of the mouth. And the same with the lower jaw. I might get a little bit of black. I do all my bass that way. I don't know if you necessarily... It doesn't hurt to do it a little bit to your kinfolk bass family, but I'll look at reference and okay. I start down the tip of the nose and I ride the lip and let my overspray hit the front of the maxilla. But since the mouth is closed, you can't really see that. But you can see me darken it up the front of the mouth. And the same with the lower jaw. I might get a little bit of black. I do all my bass that way. I don't know if you necessarily... It doesn't hurt to do it a little bit to your... I'll go around the eye. Nose here. Now usually I paint all this black too. I'll show you in a minute. But the head is, top of the head is usually about the darkest place on the fish. I don't know if you've noticed, but it usually is. On the other side of the fins, you want it to have color too. And while you got this plaque, you can also use it for painting the back of your fins. It's a good dark color. And you paint your seam and all that. It seems to have more of the detailing, you know, putting that in. On all my fins, using a reference picture, it kind of showed me how light it is. Same with the anal and the other fins, and that's for a reason, because they are a little bit lighter on the ends. So keep that in mind also. Now what I've got here, I've got iridescent blue, and just to add a little bit to it, I like to put a little bit on the base of the dorsals, just so you can see a little sparkle every now and then. Right there at the base. Same with the tail. See a little bit. Same with the anal. Same with these. And I like to even go along the back just a little. Go down to about the lateral line. You can go in between the spots or just kind of miss you a little bit. And you will be careful. And stop at about the lateral line to be fine. And right here on the cheek, I like to put a little bit of a healthy amount of the top of the gill plate and the cheek. And believe it or not, we could have went lighter than that and even had a better looking fish. But now we're going to clean the eye off. Get you a Q-tip and put you a little bit of lacquer thinner on it. And you don't want too much. You want to roll it one time in a paper towel or something like that so it don't drip down your paint job. And then you go ahead and clean your eye off. And you don't have a white ring because we cleaned the white off earlier, so there's no white to show. If that makes any sense. I forgot a place right here on the pectoral. Could have went ahead and put a little bit of this transparent orange up into the fin a little. Just to add a little bit of life to it. Okay. What else you can do? Now, something else you can do, you can kind of like just real lightly, so you can get your white and shade the very outer edges. Now, we already detailed it with the black, and since we already done that, we want to be a little bit careful. Since white is so opaque, we want to get the effect that we want to get without having to repaint the whole fin, in other words. If that makes any sense. And you can do that. You can achieve that result by being real careful. just kind of lightening up these outer extremity edges here. Kind of the opposite on your other fish, I would okay, since a yellow bass is basically a white fish, you can bring some of the white back in it if you feel like you took too much out. Because this is an opaque color. You get carried away and really, if you're not careful, mess the fish up. You don't want to do that. But so that is white. Going up to that. Now remember, some of them areas around here were actually in orange. So we want to keep those in. May have to go over it again with a little bit more black to make it look right. But if you have to, that's okay. Because the main thing is you get your fish to look the way you want it to look. Get your fish to look the way you want it to look. I'll show you a few things about some head work and the white bass that we done was a closed mouth, but what if it's an open mouth? Well, here we got white, and what we usually do, you paint the lower jaw of the fish, you know, in the belly of the bass or whatever, and but like on all skin mounts, you definitely want to get rid of the orange that shows up. A lot of people on skin mounts, they'll leave these little dead orange spots or not put enough paint and they'll show up later. So make sure you get enough white on there. You know, make sure you got the fish sealed good. That way, even though it's a tinning method, the paint job will last for years because you took the time to cover up all the places that would show through after about 10 years. So keep that in mind. I'm going to show you some more head work. If the fish is an open mouth, you want to use your off-white that you painted your belly with. You go ahead and whiten inside your fish, inside the head, or inside the mouth. And make sure it's good and white. And you can even paint the gills white. I've been known to do that. They show up better. They're gonna. If you're doing a skin mount, all you're gonna worry about is you paint the whole fish white anyway. But if you're doing a skin mount, you just proceed up from the belly and paint the gills. That's pretty much what I do. And you can paint up out here and. Now this is just, if I do a skin mount, I get all that dead orange off, right around here, around the mouth, and I'm going to put that stuff back in anyway. It doesn't bother me a bit, because I've done so many reproductions, that it doesn't scare me or anything, I guess. And on the tinning method, I usually paint my fins white, along with the belly. That's what I do. Now say you get everything all good and white, I'll show you what we do next. Okay, just done was an open mouth. Well, here's what I do. I start right here in the dip of the nose, right here in the dip of the top lip, with whatever color it calls for. Okay, now here's something else I do. It's not after mine. Okay, now when I get, after I paint right here in the dip of the lip, a lot of times what I'll do I'll let some of the spray hit the front of the lip and let whatever I need to let go back and hit the front of the mandible. And then let them both come together and meet right down here. So I'll show you again. Let the overspray go past some of the overspray go past that lip that I'm painting, and hit the front of the maxillary, come together and meet right there. Now right here on this nose bridge, I can put a little bit of paint, and then come down, let some of the paint hit the front of this maxillary, and in the back of the lip. I do that a lot. And then of course, I get the back of the maxillary, depending on the fish, it's usually right in here. Now I'll show you the bottom lip also needs your attention too. Some of your spray may come back and hit these scales, and it's good. It'll actually highlight the scales. Something else I'll show you, like, make believe there's an eye in here. What I usually do is go right around the eye with my paint, and eventually the coffin work is always painted over, so you can't see the top. But that little carapace, or whatever you call it right there, I tend to paint it. Also kind of dark, just like around the repair work on my fish. And then I'll carry that darkness back here. Tend to carry about right here. Right back here. And here's when I start to kind of worry about the back, because I don't want a dark band right down through there. But that's kind of the way I do it. Sometimes I'll leave this kind of clear up in here. I'll show you the lower lip too. Something else I gotta show you is the lower lip. Right here on the lower lip, I start right here in the front, kind of go up a ways, and I kind of go up a ways on this way. I'm coloring the outside of the lower lip. Now I'll also tip this mouth. I'll go along the lower jawbone a little. And I should have had the fish up more to show you what I mean. But let your reference be your guide. You probably got a good reference. Bass have this. And about like that. That's after you've already put your other colors. Usually the color that you darken your fish up with is the color you use for all this. So I just wanted to explain that to you. Okay, say the fish we had to do, we had one to paint the gills. Well, you always stick a paper towel in his mouth. At least one, depending on the size of the fish. What that does, that keeps the paint from coming up and running your interior of your mouth that's white. So now you can use your gill red for your gills. And paint your gills up. Something else I'll show you too. Okay, now your last gill is going to be touching up against your collarbone. Well, you want to make that good and smooth and uniform too. And so it looks right. And you can even do a better job than that. But and then you make sure you paint your gills and turn the fish any way you can. If you can see it with your own eye, you should be able to get it with your airbrush and paint it red. Then you pull the paper towel out and you got a nice set of gills. Now there's also some grinders. I guess you could call them grinders or something like that. You can kind of see them on the outer edge, but I get those with a burnt sienna. all my black bass I do, and I get Percy and get all my grinders. And there's some up in the roof of the mouth even. And that, now what we do is put a little bit of gloss on our fish, gloss top coat, and I put it on light at first. It doesn't take much to cover a small fish like this. But you don't have to have a gloss gun for fish this little. Let that dry for a little while. Now I set the paint with it, but at the same time, polyurethane gloss, I tend to use it on all my fish because it has a lot more depth. Especially on the skin mounts, it really seems to help a lot. But you can use gloss top coat, but polyurethane gloss with a brush works good. You just have to watch for droplets as it dries. But you let that set for a little bit. You can go back with a second coat. Want to put it on, make sure it's good and wet looking. And, it will make the iridescence really show up. It had a tendency to want to fog up a little. Well, this will bring them out. Brings the clarity back out in your color. But this is how I paint a yellow bass. When you use iridescence, you got to be real careful not to put them on too heavy. The iridescent blue that I used, when it goes over, when it the darker the spot is, the more you can see it. And sometimes you have to turn the fish. You have to almost be afraid to put it on, because if you're not, you'll end up putting it on too heavy. And of course, I got some on the cheek and the back of the gill flap. And but I just wanted to show you that. But this is how I paint a yellow bass.